Hey guys, welcome to another video. Before I start, I just want to say sorry for the camera. I'll be really shaky because it's on an iPhone and I just can't really hold phones still. This video will be about how to use the Duo Gamer controller, the one from Gameloft obviously, on any app that isn't officially supported, that's like a Gameloft app. So such as Modern Combat 3, that's supported, but Modern Combat 4 isn't as of yet. So you can use this on Modern Combat 4. Also, you can use a PS3 controller on any app, exactly the same as how you use the Duo Gamer controller. So before I start off, I'm just going to show you a few steps that you need to get this app, and then I'm going to have half of the video about the Duo Gamer controller and half the video about the PS3 controller. So the first thing you want to do is obviously jailbreak your device. If you're not jailbroken, you cannot do this. All you have to do is just search on YouTube how to jailbreak and then say your device name. So mine's an iPad 2 running 6.1. So I'd say how to jailbreak my iPad 2 running 6.1. And then I'd do that. And you'll get an app called Cydia right there. And you just go onto that. And you'll have to, I can't even click it with one hand. You'll just have to wait a bit for the first time, because obviously it'll have to load everything. And what you want to search is called blutrol. This should be in, like, Cydia when you first start. If it's not, then comment below and I'll try and help you out. But this is basically spelled B-L-U-T-R-O-L. Okay, return to Cydia, return to Cydia, return to Cydia, return to Cydia. Okay, yeah, okay. Sorry about this, guys. But yeah, so basically you just want to install that. That's the first thing you want to do. You can just go up here and it should say install. This will work with these controllers right here. And also, as you can see, a Bluetooth controller, a keyboard, sorry. Duo Gamer, I control pad, IM Plus, I don't know what that is. Phone Joy, PS3 controller, which is this, Wii remote, and a Z-mote. So what you want to do is just install that, and that's basically all you have to do for the first part. So the first part of this video is going to be just about the PS3 controller, seeing as that is the hardest thing to do. It's not that hard, but it is the most complicated. This is a one-time setup, so you just have to follow these steps. So if you go onto the Cydia page and you scroll down a bit, then it'll say how to use how to PS3 controller. You click that, and there's two different versions. There's how to do it on the Mac and how to do it on Windows. So if you're on Mac, just follow these steps. You literally have to download 6Pertool, plug your device into the 30-pin connector or the Lightning dock into your computer, which mine's down here. Then you have to connect your PS3 controller using the cable, which looks like this cable here. Wait, let me try and will it. No. Oh wow, I'm so shaky. But yeah, you put that into there and that goes into your computer again. Once that's connected, this little thing should say your device up here, and then PS3 six axis controller connected. And you just click that button. Then all you have to do is, if you wait for a little bit, then I'll show you. You go into blutrol and then you carry on for there. But I'll show you in a second after I tell everyone how to do this on Windows. So for Windows, it's a little bit different. You want to go to Dancing Pixel Studios website. Just go onto Google. I've got it up here. If you want to type in the address there, then you can just do that. I probably won't remember, but I'll try to put that address there in the description. So what you want to do is, when you go to the home page, go to six axis controller. Wow, I cannot say that word. Six axis pair tool, and then you just install it. When you download it, make sure that you put your controller into the computer, like plug it in, so you're ready to have it connected already when you install it. So it must be connected when you install it. I guess it's because it's installing the drivers. Another note is, if you get any errors about Microsoft Visual C++, just forget about it. Just say continue or quit, whatever it says. And if you're on Windows 8 and you have problems, run it as administrator. After you've done that, you literally, I'll show you the actual program. What you want to do is you want to go onto it, and right here it will say current master and it will say a number. I'm just going to show you, I'm going to connect my PS3 controller, if I can do that with one hand, which I might be able to do it. Okay, right, so this will change to a number. This number you don't have to remember. This is all you have to, like, that's what you have to focus on. So current master is basically what Bluetooth address it's connected to right now. And to change the master, you literally have to type it in. So to do that, you want it to be connected to your iPad. So what you want to do is you want to go to settings or on your iPhone. You want to go to general, and you want to go to about, which is up here. And if you go down to the bottom, it should say Bluetooth right there. And if you move along, it says your Bluetooth address right there. That's literally all you have to do, is put that into there, which I've already done. That's why my current master is my iPad, so that's my iPad's address. And then all you want to do is you want to go into Blutrol. So this is the part where you can use the, this is the part for the Duo Game controller as well. So what you want to do is, if I just click on that, and I'll just close this down really quickly, if I can actually, there we go, right. Thumbs up for my wallpaper, by the way, guys. It's Elder Scrolls Online. Anyway, so this is for both Duo Gamer Controller and the PS3, if you already know how to connect it and stuff, but once you've got your PS3 controller connected, you literally just pull it out of the computer, which I can't do with one hand, and all the lights will go off. Next, you want to add a game, so mine's going to be Dead Trigger, and I've got a picture of it before. You have to take a screenshot of your app, and then that's my screenshot there, if I can actually get that. And then it will say controller configuration. Oh yeah, by the way, if you want to add a game, you have to go to the top right and click add, and then you have to select the game, select the screenshot, and then the controller configuration, which I've already done here. So you click that, and then you get a list of like controllers that you could use. So Duo Gamer or PS3 controller, the two that we're going to use. PS3 controller is the one I'm going to use. Landscape. And then you'll get your screenshots. So this is within the start of the game. The thing to know about this is it doesn't have dual analog sticks on this app. So for some reason, just place in like one of the analog sticks on the side doesn't really work. I'm not sure if it works on this one. I've never tried it. But seeing as this is the aim area, I know it's like half the screen's the aim area in Dead Trigger, so I'm just going to have that like that. You can resize the analog sticks and the D-pad. This is a D-pad. These are the analog sticks, so you can just resize them. And I'm going to put that there. Wait, let me just look out the camera. So you guys can look at my controller as I do this. So I'm going to put that. L1 is that. No, L1 can be, no, wait, no, right, no, what's this, that's R1, R1 can be shoot, there we go, reload can be square, right, so I'm just kind of doing that now. Then if you just move all the ones you don't need off to the side, and you click done, then what you can do is, wait, what have I, yeah, so you've done that, then you go to the bottom, click your controller, and then, so these are the ones, this is why this is easier on a Duo Gamer and an iCade, because these are already on the Bluetooth. So I want PS3 controller, which is here. I tap that, and there'll be a tick next to it. And then you go back to the beginning. Where is it? Wait, no, it's here. Never mind. You click connect to the bottom. It'll say activating BT stack. And you press the home button on your PS3 controller. And that did it really quickly, but it won't normally. But it will have the first light on, and that means it's connected. So now we can go into our game, which I hope hasn't quit. Right, okay, so resume. There we go, guys. So, look, this is what happens. It's kind of weird. I mean, it kind of works. But it kind of doesn't. But it does work, guys. I mean, mean, it's really good. I think if they add support for the analog sticks, then, like, for looking around, then it would be better, because this doesn't really work. It goes right, and it, like, flicks back. It's weird. So now I'm going to show you how to do the exact same with a Joy Gamer controller. So this is literally simple. By the way, if you want to turn this off, the only way I've found to turn it off is if you quit the blutrol app, which I'll just do now. Just quit that, and I'm going to quit that game. So I'm going to show you the Duo Game controller. This light will go off, by the way, on the PS3 controller. So the Duo Game controller. This video is going to be really messy. It's all, like, everywhere. Anyway, so, taking off from the step where you've got your device, you jailbroken it, you've got Cydia, you've got blutrol, so you've got the app. All you have to do is, I like doing this before I open blutrol, is if you turn your controller on, and you go into Bluetooth, obviously turn that on, and then it will say your, wait, let me just press this again, and then you click on your controller, hopefully it will actually connect, your light should be blinking now. And also guys, if you're on an app, then at the top here there's like a little Bluetooth icon that should come on. No, you can't really see that. Oh, come on. Connect. So, this sometimes happens. I'm just going to turn that on and off again. Right, let me just turn that on and off. I'm sorry, guys. This is going to be a long video. 11 minutes 41. And it's going to be longer, seeing as I have an intro. Come on. Okay, right. Now, it's better if you turn your Bluetooth on first, and then you press this, or it won't really work. So, after that, it should have connected automatically, but obviously not. Right, okay, now it's connected. Now what you want to do is, you want to go into blutrol, which is there. Let me just, okay. So, I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to show you Modern Combat. No, I'm not, actually. That's going to take ages. Actually, no, I'll show you Modern Combat 3. No, I'm not, because that's very... I'll just show you Ice Rage. So, Ice Rage is a game which has a little... not a duo gamer stick. What am I thinking? An analog stick at the bottom, and then there's a one button, and you basically have to play hockey with that. So what you want to do is you want to press add game, and then it'll come up with a list of games. So it'll come up with this, and you click on your game, and you just choose which game you want. Then you choose your screenshot, which I've got already. And then you can add a control, or you can just configure ones you've already got. So this is one landscape, you want to click landscape. This is one that I've already got. So this L represents this left analog stick. And the A is obviously this A button right here. And then all the other ones I just moved off to the side because I don't need them, if I can just move that there. Then obviously, if you double tap, then this brings up that. Then you're done. And you go into your app, your game, whatever, which is, where is it? I don't know. Okay, it's up here. So this is the app. If I could just kind of somehow use one hand to record. Right, so, obviously you just choose your game, quick match, right, I'm hoping this is working, is this working? No, this is not working, this isn't working, I think I know why, this might be a bit, right, you have to click your, I've got this before. Even though your controller is connected, you have to go into the little controller tab at the bottom there. And if you go to the top, and you have to tap Duo Gamer so it's got the little tick. So it knows that you're using the Duo Gamer controller. Then you can go into your app, and it should actually work. Personally, I like using the Duo Gamer controller for officially released games by GameLoft. Right, here we go. This is working now. As you can see, the stick there's moving, and you can see that button's getting hit, and then my character's kind of like moving up the screen. So this is actually really good. I'm just going to try and... I've got it. Wait, let me just kind of... I can't focus right now. But yeah, so that's basically it, guys. If you have any questions, which I doubt you won't have any, seeing as my video is extremely confusing, extremely long, so just kind of comment, because I know this is a really bad video. I've literally tried to record this like 20 times, and I just kept saying stuff wrong. I kept calling this a blutrol controller, so, you know, and then I kept going to connect the 666